Hello, happy Saturday, I think it is, on the day I'm recording this. I wanted to do some sort of fun Halloween related activity. So today we're going to be painting rocks with like Halloween designs on them, and then I'm going to decorate my apartment windowsill with them. So we have various rocks here. I got this rock painting kit online. I think it's actually for children, but anybody can do it. And my artistic ability, or at least my painting abilities, are probably pretty on par with that of a child. So, okay, let's choose a rock first. Let's see, this one is kind of big. Let's go with this one. Or no, actually, this one. I think this would make a good pumpkin. We'll start with a pumpkin. Little paints here. We have various different colors of paint. And of course, I think we'll use the orange for the pumpkin. And then we have, it came with two different paintbrushes, I think. Obviously, this is for like detailing, so I'll use this one. Let's see, it came with some googly eyes. And a sponge, which I'm not really sure how I will put this to use, but and it came with markers, possibly for drawing on faces. Clothing while I'm painting, but I guess I have faith in myself. Just going to paint an orange base. I think I'll paint the whole rock. I think I'll just paint the face of it, because well, I don't know why, but I don't want to get too much paint on the table. So we painted it orange. I'm just going to paint multiple rocks, like paint the base color, and then paint on the faces after I give them a minute to dry. Okay, I have some water. We'll do this bigger one. We'll do it bright pink. Or kind of like a magenta color. I can't remember the last. I did do a kind of like an abstract painting that I have hanging up. But that was probably last year. And then before that, I probably hadn't painted in years. I was reading the reviews for this product, and somebody said that their 4-year-old and 6-year-old children really enjoyed this. So I was like, I could probably do it too. If a 4-year-old and a 6-year-old can do it, I can probably manage. And it seems like they're drying very quickly. I think I'll do maybe use the googly eyes on this rock. And then I'll just do like crazy, scary faces on these. I don't know. Like monsters. Okay, I think I'll do this one a purple color. Or no, actually, let's do a nice blue color on this rock. I always think that I should get more into doing like arts and crafts activities because I think it's a very soothing sort of hobby to pick up. It gives your mind something to focus on, and then at the end of the project, you have something. nothing here, just painting rocks. Be considered a brown color, brownish. It almost looks like a mix of brown and purple, which is, I don't know, you probably can't see it. You probably can't see it very well on the camera. Okay, so the orange one seems to be already dry. We'll just let the brush soak for a minute. Let's see. So, oh, okay, so I do have black paint right here. They both look like black, but I think that's only one of them is. I'm trying to picture in my mind what it would do next. Pumpkin. You have like lines in a pumpkin going vertical, so I suppose that's what I'll do. Hands are like extra shaky, but oh my goodness, I think this actually looks like. Just gonna change it. This isn't a pumpkin anymore. It's just an orange creature. Okay. Because this is just not like, what is that? That doesn't look like a pumpkin. Okay, well, that's fine. Okay. I'll just put on some eyeballs because I feel like googly eyes makes everything look better. Here, I'm gonna dump them all out so I can see them better. Surprisingly difficult to remove, like the sticky part of it. Because I don't know, there's like the back isn't really coming off. So maybe I can use this glitter. I'll just use glitter to stick it on. Okay, here we go. Let's just just do a glittery striped pumpkin. They say you can never have too much glitter. Okay, look, this is actually looking really good. Yeah, okay, see. Let's just leave it like that. No mouth. Just eyes. Okay, I think we're done with that. He actually learned a valuable lesson from that. Don't squeeze so hard when using the glitter tubes, because glitter will get everywhere. Okay, now let's do the blue rock, because it seems to be mostly dried. I think for this one, we'll do and we'll just draw on something, some sort of face. He needs more pizzazz, don't you think? Maybe what he needs is he's fine just the way he is. Okay. Now for the pink. temperature. Well, I don't know if it's a ghost, but it's like a smirking, like poltergeist.